as we discussed a little bit in the two halachas in 60 seconds, it's quite an interesting time we're living in. Especially now, Chol HaMoed, I just came back from a levaya. Two levayas. Used to be you go to two chasanas, three chasanas. And unfortunately now, a person goes shows up to a Beis Olamim and sees two good friends that both lost parents. And it's beyond the difficult. And at the same time, I think one of the biggest challenges is the fact that Avelus doesn't even begin until after Yontif. So there's it's very difficult for a person. On the one hand, they are in a little bit of mourning state, but it's not public, and they don't sit Shiva, but they sit Shiva afterwards. In a way, it's actually much more of a blessing. And again, obviously, Hashem runs the world. Someone once asked me, how is it possible that right before Yontif, if someone sits for a few seconds, they don't have to sit Shiva? How does that even work? So Kabbalistically, there's a fascinating explanation. The whole idea of Shiva and Shloshim, so sometimes we look at it, can't wash, can't bathe, can't buy new clothing. What is that all about? Really, it's a chesed for the nifter, for the person that passed away, because they have to go through different stages. They're going through a journey. And by us keeping, people keeping the different laws, it actually mitigates the judgment and the difficulties. So a person that gives a little bit more of an appreciation. But one of the people that was just mamish buried was a person by the name of Shlema Kabesa. I think he learned half of Shas almost with me in Daf Yomi. And someone reminded me, because this is the week of Chesed, so I want to publicly even thank him, is that he used to make oatmeal after the Daf Yomi. Sometimes a person could be in a Daf Yomi and find his thing that they're going to do. What would he do? Geshmaka oatmeal at the end of the Daf Yomi. And there's such a warm memory. What an amazing thing, Chesed, that the person goes to eternity with such a small, quote-unquote, small life. Not such a simple act. You have to know how to make geshmaka oatmeal. But it made me also think that here we are holding in Netzach Shebechesed. So we started speaking about Sfiras Ayim. I'm going to try as much as we can to deepen our understanding and to live day by day, because this, as we said, are incredible days, really incredible days. This week specifically is the week of Chesed, of course. So when we speak about Netzach Shebech Chesed, we're speaking about, so Chesed, what's Chesed? The Zohar says that Chesed, the root of Chesed is Ahava, is love of Hashem. This week we have to, as much as we can, and as challenging as it is, to come to Ahavas Hashem. I told someone when I was walking away from the burial that in Kabbalah, in the Zohar, when it speaks about a yurtzeit, someone's petira, speaks about kol yom dehilula. It means a chasana, because really, they're having a chasana. They're getting married to the Ribono Shel Olam. They're in the best place. Really, the pain is, of course, the people here that lost this person. But a person shouldn't lose sight of it and the perspective. So here we are, we're talking about Netzach Shebechesed. What a connection. Because every death, really, by Judaism, the most comforting part of death is the fact that it's a temporary journey from one world to the next. Mamash, it's a nesiyah, it's a trip. But the neshama lives for eternity. Someone a yid, someone that learned half a shas, someone that did chesed, someone that's busy with mitzvahs, what a schus. And even the people that couldn't, honest, they can't, but they're part of yid and a yid, just a yid and a yiddish and a shama. So netzach shebechesed, what we could focus on today is the fact that we could come to love Hashem. This is part of netzach shebechesed. The fourth day of Sfira is that we could come to love Hashem through the fact that He's eternal. Through the fact that Hashem's kindness and chesed is not something that stops, it never stops, it's an infinite. What a comforting thought. Have an amazing day.